Hello, I am Vedant Paranjpe. This is the intro video for my Google Summer of Code 2020 project under beagleboard.org. My mentors are Abhishek Kumar, Pratim Ugale, Andrew Henderson. My project aims to improve the infrastructure for the PRU. I am a second year electronics engineering student at Veer Mata Jizabai Technological Institute. My areas of interest are system development, native desktop app development, digital signal processing, and embedded system development. The PRU is a dual-core microcontroller system present on the AM335X system on chip, which powers the BeagleBone. It is meant to be used for high-speed jitter-free input-output control. Being independent from the Linux scheduler and having direct access to the input-output pins of the BeagleBone Black, the PRU is ideal for offloading input-output intensive tasks and real-time tasks. Programming the PRU is an uphill task for a beginner, since it involves several steps. This can be an easy task for an experienced developer, but it keeps many creative developers away. This can be achieved by implementing a language on top of the PRU assembly. It will directly compile down to PRU assembly. This could also be solved by implementing a bytecode engine on the PRU, but this will result in waste of already limited resources on the PRU. With this approach, both PRU cores can be run independent of each other. The goals for this project are as follows. Implement a language for PRU which compiles down to PRU assembly. This language is called SimPRU, named so as this language would provide an easy way to program the PRU with an easy to understand syntax. Solve issues on AM335 PRU package, namely issues 44, 41, and 49. Update PRU speak to work with the latest kernel. Since it uses remote proc and RP message framework, whose API keeps on changing with each kernel revision, as a result, this project does not work with current kernel version. Getting this running is important since PRU speaks is an easy way for beginners to get started with the PRU. The BeagleBoard is a low power open source single board computer produced by Texas Instruments in association with DigiKey and NAVARC Element 14. The BeagleBoard was also designed with open source software development in mind and as a way of demonstrating the Texas Instruments OMAP3530 system on a chip. The board was developed by a small team of engineers as an educational board that could be used in colleges around the world to teach open source hardware and software capabilities. The board which I am going to implement a SimPRU is BeagleBone Black Wireless. A programmable real-time unit, also called as PRU, is a fast processor with single cycle input-output access to a number of the pins and full access to the internal memory and peripherals on the AM3358 processor on BeagleBones. They are designed to provide software-defined peripherals as a part of the programmable real-time unit industrial control subsystem, also called as PRU-ICSS, and are capable of implementing things like 25 pulse width modulators, 4 soft UARTs, stepper motor drivers, and much more. Having these controllers integrated is really handy to avoid throwing in another device to control or interface to a new peripheral. SimPRU. SimPRU intends to be a statically typed language. It has a simple to understand syntax and takes away most of the difficult to understand parts needed to code the PRU. As you can see the examples below, the one on the left side is a LED blink code written in C and one on the right is the LED blink code written in SimPRU. As you can see, the SimPRU code is reduced and easier for a beginner to understand. Now coming to the implementation part. This language will be implemented using Flex to generate a scanner and Bison to generate a parser. This code will convert into LLVM intermediate representation language. LLVM will convert the code into its assembler representation. Using CLPRU assembler, the ASM code will be converted to a binary which will be loaded by remote proc. Rather than writing a loader program to control the PRU, a kernel module will handle loading, unloading of firmware, and starting, stopping, or resuming the PRU. This kernel module will use remote proc APIs in the backend to handle this. Coming to the next goal, that is updating the PRU speaks to run with the latest kernel. PRU speaks is a previous GSoC project which lets us use PRU like an interpreter, but since it uses remote proc, it often breaks with changes in the rproc API. This can be mitigated by adding an abstract layer between PRU speaks and rproc API. Thus, this layer will never change, and whenever API for rproc changes, the backend of this abstraction layer can be easily updated rather than making extensive changes in the code of PRU speaks. One might ask, what are the benefits of doing this project? There are many. Currently, interfacing with the PRU requires a lot of makefile manipulation, kernel drivers, and stuff. Implementing this language will make it easier for beginners to get started. Implementing a bytecode engine on PRU slows down execution speed and wastes already limited resources. Since this language compiles down to PRU assembly, this does not have any overhead. It hides away all the ugly stuff in PRUC, like bit shifts needed several times, gives a clean user-friendly interface so that a beginner can easily get started with the PRU. Ending this introductory video, I would like to thank all my mentors, BeagleBoat.org and Google Summer of Code for giving me this wonderful opportunity to create an interesting project.